Hi, Taylor.
Hi, good afternoon.
You're the head of AIM's imprint at Goldman Sachs, which invests with managers and co-investments focused on ESG and impact strategies. How has impact investing fared generally during the pandemic?
Yeah, COVID has really accelerated existing trends across the industry and shown a greater spotlight on ESG. And in fact, in public markets, ESG assets crossed the $1 trillion threshold recently, driven largely by growth in ESG strategies from April through June. And the focus has really been on more resilient and sustainable business models that take in consideration multiple stakeholders, as well as can take advantage of green-focused government recovery programs, particularly in Europe.
Any specific pockets of interest that you're seeing from investors?
We've seen really continuation of trends or acceleration of trends in across multiple industries, with digitization, one obvious one in education, as families turn towards remote learning, as well as in healthcare as telemedicine becomes much more widely adopted, and there's been a greater kind of regulatory support for telemedicine and due to COVID. We've also seen resiliency in other themes such as clean energy, which have been less directly impacted by the drop in oil and gas prices and are expected to continue to be the predominant technology used in new power installations globally going forward. Some themes have been directly impacted to the downside. Ride sharing applications and any investments tied to mass transportation in transportation theme have been negatively impacted. But investments in electric vehicles and electric vehicle infrastructure and autonomous vehicle technologies have all seen significant growth. And then directly impacted has been obviously the food and agriculture sector. We've seen continued momentum and growth in alternative proteins, as there's been health concerns around meat, and then also healthy consumer products have also been significant sales growth, mainly through online store sales.
So obviously interest in impact investing was growing before the pandemic. What have been the major drivers of that growth?
Yeah, we see two pretty fundamental drivers that are driving the growth of impact investing, climate-related natural disasters and rising levels of income inequality. And companies and investors have really started to take note of the potential financial impact of these trends. And just a couple of examples, last year we had 15 of the most destructive natural disasters, each of which cost over $1 billion, and seven of which were more than $10 billion each. And this year, living in California, we've now burned over 3.5 million acres of land going into the worst part of the fire season, versus 300,000 acres on average historically. And all of these are natural disasters are directly linked to climate change. And at the same time, we have rising wealth inequality that really hinders opportunity and growth. This was happening pre-COVID, and COVID will only increase these trends. But today, you know, the world's richest 1% own half of the global wealth. And we haven't seen, you know, this level of inequality since the 1920s. And we see opportunities in inclusive growth across financial inclusion, education, and healthcare to try to mitigate unequal access among and affordability among underserved populations.
And what are you seeing from different types of investors focused on these strategies?
So we see accelerated interest across individuals, institutions, and corporates, with corporates being most notable in terms of recent commitments to decarbonize their companies. And over the last year, we've seen over $11 billion in corporate commitments to purchase voluntary carbon mitigants. And one example of this is actually Microsoft, which has agreed to offset all of their emissions since their founding in 1975 and invest $1 billion in a climate innovation fund to help accelerate the development of carbon reduction and removal technologies. We think these corporate commitments are going to accelerate capital flows, particularly into the climate transition theme, and help develop new technologies to help address the worst of climate change.
And what about private investors?
Private investors are equally focused on climate change, but are also looking at social issues, particularly around income inequality and racial and gender equity. And a lot of the events over the summer has shown an increased spotlight on diversity and inclusion, and investors are increasingly looking for more diverse teams to back as they allocate their capital.
And what sorts of investment products are investors gravitating towards?
So ESG has really become almost ubiquitous in public markets, and particularly in Europe. And there's now regulation in Europe that's going to require analysis of ESG across strategies. And this has really been driven by investor demand for these types of products. But it's really key to understand where ESG is fundamentally part of the investment process versus highlighted more for marketing purposes. In private markets, the predominant trend has been larger private equity firms more actively integrating ESG into their investment process, as well as launching dedicated impact strategies for the first time, bringing much greater scale and later stage focus to impact investing. And this is really done across private equity, real assets, and private credit asset classes.
Finally, Taylor, a long-running criticism of impact investing is that it requires investors to make a financial trade-off for impact. What's your perspective on that?
So we've been investing in ESG and impact strategies for over 10 years and certainly haven't seen a financial trade-off. While many of these themes are more nascent and lack robust data, we believe kind of industry and macro tailwinds will continue to drive growth in these areas. But it does require a more research-oriented investment approach to find those opportunities. We also are very much focused on investments where the impact and the financial outcomes are aligned. Where you would see an issue in terms of trade-off is where there was a divergence between those two outcomes. And we also think the measurement of impact is quite important and requires a detailed assessment of underlying business models and how those align with an impact thesis and the specific metrics that come off of those investments to be able to demonstrate the impact value of these investments.
Thanks, Taylor.
Yeah, thank you for having me.